Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill them. Amen, I say to you, until heaven and earth pass away, not the smallest letter or the smallest part of a letter will pass from the law until all things have taken place. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do so will be called the least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever obeys and teaches these commandments will be called greatest in the kingdom of heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
The fulfillment of the law is love. Jesus came not to abolish the law, or to change even the smallest letter of the law, or the smallest part of the letter, like the dot in the letter I, but to fulfill the law. And how does one fulfill the law? When we say law, it refers to the law of Moses, the Pentateuch, the first five books, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy. These are the books that are very important to the Jews because these are the basis of their way of life, their moral life, the rules on food, relationship, harvest, worship are all listed in these books. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Pentateuch, first five books. Prophets, of course, refer to the major and minor prophets, meaning to say all of the Old Testament. I came not to abolish the Old Testament, but to fulfill the Old Testament. And how does one fulfill the commandment of God? Of course, there's a list of the commandments and the greatest of the commandments. The list of the commandments, for example, commandments on, there are 613 commandments in the law of Moses. So the least, for example, the commandment on tithing, you have to pay 10% of your income, okay, temple tax, etc. These are also commandments, but least commandments. The greatest commandments are 10. So the 10 commandments of God, and Jesus summarized them into two, the love of God and the love of neighbor, in this correct order. First, the love of God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your strength, with all your soul, and love your neighbor as you love yourself. So, two sides of a coin. Love is the fulfillment of 613 commandments, least commandments, least of the commandments, and the greatest of the commandments. So, Jesus came not to abolish the law, but to fulfill the law, because during that time, he was seen as the one who is violating the orthodoxy. He is teaching another doctrine. But Jesus said, "No, I'm not teaching another doctrine. I'm just fulfilling the law." So the question again is, how does one fulfill the law? Two ways. You fulfill the law by its correct understanding. When you have the correct understanding and interpretation of the law, you fulfill the law. If you have a wrong interpretation and wrong application of the law, you violate the law. So fulfillment is in the correct understanding, mind, and interpretation of the law. The second way to fulfill the law is to keep it, to obey it, to put it into action. So you fulfill the law. Love your parents. You have correct understanding of this love of parents. And then you love your parents. Then you fulfill, you perfect the law. you keep the law, you observe the law, then the law is fulfilled. So the law is fulfilled by its correct understanding and interpretation, and Jesus gave them the correct interpretation, not the interpretation of other rabbis, and the putting into practice of this law in the form of love. Love your neighbor, love God, and love your neighbor. So ano ang nagmatabo sini? Kung may law, may layers na. Okay, so ari ang iyang pasahon ko na lang gid ang iyang interpretation. Inside out transformation, that's the purpose of the law. So in the inside out nature of Jesus' teaching on the kingdom life, it can be illustrated by thinking of his disciples as concentric layers that eventually penetrate to the core of the person. Ang context, ang mga pariseyo, ang ilang pag-fulfill sa law, outside in. So, mangugas ka sa imo kamot, titinlo na imo heart eh. Ugasan mo tong mga repolyo mo, mga sibuyas mo, titinlo na to eh. Ritual purity lang, external. Ihaw ka sang karnero, bisan may aligot-got ka sa imo sigkataw, kay nag-ihaw ka sa karnero, kag naghalad sa Dios, titinlo ka na eh. Na, amo na external. Kay ritual. Fulfillment of rites, rituals. Pero man sa aton, sabi mo nakasimba ka na, tinlo ka na, no? Sabi mo ka nakasuksok ka sa mga bayo-bayo na, sabi mo daw holy ka na, no? Hindi automatic. Sabi mo naka-offer ka na, sabi mo tinlo ka na, pure, no? Sabi mo nag-donate ka, sabi mo patawad sa la mo, no? Namo na daw, apply naton sa aton kabuhinga. External lang, sabi naton, tinlo na kita dayon. Ha, naghatag ka lang sang bulak kay St. Joseph o kay ano na, sabi mo, tinlo ka na dayon, no? Amo naging correct ni Jesus. Kaya hindi amo na. Gina-keep niyo ang commandments from in your heart. Sabi mo, nag-praise ka sa Dios, your lips, nag-praise sa Dios, pero heart, layo sa Dios. That's not transformation. Okay? Sabi mo, ginbutangan mo lang balay mo sang altar, holy ka na. Kaya ito, may altar balay mo, no? Hindi automatic. So, you get the point. So, holiness, hindi sa external. Hindi outside in, nga dekorahan mo parang matinlo ka, kundi inside out, halin sa gwa, kag maapektuhan ang imo social environment. So, muna ang context. That's why the inside out nature of Jesus' teaching of the kingdom life can be illustrated by thinking of his disciples as concentric layers that eventually penetrate to the core of the person. We are soulish persons with souls, which indicates that we are a complex of immaterial and material realities, spiritual and material. Our outermost layer consists of social environment or social relations. Di kung dira ka lang mag-dwell sa imo ya transformation, sa system, sa structure, sa mga kung ano dira, kung amo nang imo transformation, outer layer lang na transform mo. That's why sa society, kung i-rearrange mo lang da kung sino ga pulungko da sa position without transformation of the heart, mga problema kita gyapon. Wala ka nag-change sang inner core. Ang gin-change mo na ya, ang tao lang, na parareho man lang. Nagbailuhanay lang sila. Awan sa simbahan. Oh. Kung wala sang transformation, ipinkambyuhan mo lang sila, parareho mo lang na sila. Amo nang namin ni Jesus. So, kung ang imo transformation sa social relations lang, like what the Sadducees and the Pharisees and the scribes were doing, so hindi wala sang righteousness, wala sanctification. What I know first about a person are the relationships I share or see the other person engage in, whether in a class or in a family or on the street. The next inward layer is the body, including what the person wears, how she carries herself, the way she talks, what she looks like, and so on. So, iban may mga transformation, may mga body enhancement procedure. So, nagwapa siya, pero actually wala siya sang core change sa sulod. Kahit body man lang ang nag-change sa iya or ang iya apparels. You know what I mean. Kagang kalibutan ang muna gusto iya, i-change siya ang body, pero hindi niya mag-change ang heart. Next level, hambalya, is the level of the mind or worldview. The mind is where the person reasons, considers emotions, and experiences spiritual realities. So, much deeper transformation. I think that's the role of education. Pero kung education is to teach people to transform the outside and to transform only the body and the things inside the house without transforming the heart, may kulang ang education. Because education is the education also of the mind, worldview, what is right and wrong. You are able to distinguish and you are able to choose what is correct. Sa mo ng transformation. Ngayon, gina-feed kita sa kalibutan sa mind sa mga false na narratives, false interpretation. Ito ang kalibutan, ganyan, nag-poison sa mind naton kasi aton kabataan. Gina-feed ang body, pero ang heart, wala yung gina-feed. So, mo nang na-correct ni Jesus. And then, hambalya, the deepest layer of the person is the heart, in which includes the person's will and the spirit. So, hambalya, it's the conversion of the heart. It's the transformation of the heart. So, ang law is not only to change the outside. It's not only to change the body, material things. It's also to change. That's why very important ang law. And therefore, the lawmaker should be aware of this. Because law creates culture. Kung mag-create ka sang law, kina-create mo ang culture, lifestyle, kina-protect mo ang what is protected by the law, kina-support mo, ginatagaan mo budget, kina-lifestyle. So, kung bad lifestyle, kag may law, kag-support, ga-create siya sang culture. So that's why hambal ni Christ, law must support sa change of heart and inner transformation. And that's what the program of Jesus is. Okay, it's not the change from the outside, but change from the inside. The kingdom values, the spiritual values. That's it. Amo nang hambal ni Jesus, I do not abolish the law, but I'll teach you the meaning of the law and the purpose of the law. This is the correct interpretation of the law. It's the transformation of person to become more like God, to imitate God. That's the purpose of the law. And sanctification of the law. So, may we continue to obey the law of God, to respect the law, because the law is not our enemy, it's our guidance and enlightenment, so that we can grow in our spirituality and live our morality. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ reminded us that we need laws in this world because we are imperfect persons and we need guidance. But we know that incorrect law creates incorrect culture. Wrong laws create wrong culture because of the wrong interpretation. Grant us your wisdom, most especially the church, to interpret your laws and create cultures based on this law, which is the law of love of God and love of neighbor. You live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.